In this video, I will explain you a basic anatomy of rotator cuff. Rotator cuff is made by four muscles, tiny muscles, so I will describe one by one with bony structure of scapula. The first muscle is here. It originates from here. This part is called infraspinous fossa. Infraspinous fossa. Fossa means kind of concave surface on the bone. So this is concave place called infraspinous fossa. From infraspinous fossa, there is muscle called infraspinatus. From infraspinous fossa, infraspinatus is here. This infraspinatus muscle does external rotation of shoulder joint. External rotation is you twist arm this way. Infraspinatus from infraspinous fossa. There's one more muscle originates from posterior side of scapula. By the way, this is posterior side of scapula, back side. One more muscle from back side. From here, this is called lateral border of scapula. It's kind of middle of lateral border. One muscle originates from here, which is called teres minor. Teres minor is running like this. Infraspinatus is running like this. Infraspinatus, teres minor. This muscle also does external rotation. You twist shoulder arm this way. External rotation. So, infraspinatus, teres minor, these two muscles do external rotation because these two muscles pull arm this way. So this is two out of four muscles. Let's look at one more muscle. The one muscle originates from here, this very curvy concave surface. Remember what its structure, concave structure called? Fossa. So this part is called supraspinous fossa. From supraspinous fossa, one muscle originates from here. It is called supraspinatus. We had infraspinatus, and we have supraspinatus from here. If you look carefully, this part is called acromion process of scapula. Supraspinatus is running like this. If you look closely, this is head of humerus, and this is acromion. This space in between these two bones are very narrow. So supraspinatus is very easy to get impingement here. That's why supraspinatus is usually get injured. From supraspinous fossa, supraspinatus. Actually, infraspinatus, teres minor, and supraspinatus attach on here. It is called greater tubercle. Three of four rotator cuffs attach on greater tubercle. Let's see the last one. You are watching from front side. This is front part of scapula. This part is called subscapular fossa. Again, you got a fossa, subscapular fossa. So one muscle originates from subscapular fossa. What is it? It is called subscapularis. Subscapularis is running like this, attached here. It is called lesser tubercle. We just looked greater tubercle, and we have lesser tubercle. Subscapularis originates from subscapular fossa, running like this. Let's review all four muscles. Infraspinatus originates from infraspinous fossa. Teres minor from lateral border and running like this. Supraspinous fossa, supraspinatus, running below the acromion, this bone, and attach on greater tubercle. From front side, subscapular fossa, subscapularis originates. So these are four muscles of rotator cuff. So this is very important muscle. If you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe.